first to breaking news where two people have died and several others injured when a train carrying more than 150 passengers from Sydney to Melbourne derailed. We have extensive coverage from our reporters on the ground. Let's go to First Nine's Andrew Lund at Wallen Station, north of Melbourne. Good morning to you, Andrew. When will the wreckage be removed?
Well, Tracy, that's likely to take a couple of days. Obviously, most of the train is off to the side of the tracks. It derailed just north of here, a bit before 8 o'clock last night. It killed, obviously, two people, including the driver. A couple of those carriages ended up on their side. The others, though, were fairly upright. Dozens and dozens of passengers on board, very lucky that they were able to climb off with relatively minor injuries. But obviously this is the main train line between Melbourne and Sydney. It is currently closed, so all the morning commuters trying to get into Melbourne are being forced onto buses, and it's likely that this rail link between Melbourne and Sydney will be closed for at least a few days to come after this very serious incident overnight.
Yeah, it'll be quite the recovery. All right, Andrew Lund, thank you. Now to Nine's Mark Santomartino at Northern Hospital, where a number of the passengers are recovering there. Mark, authorities say it's lucky more people weren't injured.
Well, given how violently they were thrown from their seats, Tracy, police say it's a miracle that the eight people who were brought here to the Northern Hospital only have minor injuries. Three more with similar injuries were taken to the Kilmore Hospital. I'm told that a man aged in his 60s is in a slightly worse condition. He has been taken to the Royal Melbourne with upper body injuries. Of course, they were part of the 160 passengers on board this XPT train, which derailed just before 8 o'clock last night. Unfortunately, the air ambulances which were called to the scene were not needed after the driver as well as another employee died in that crash. There was a makeshift triage centre set up at a nearby BP service station for hours. Passengers were cared there by paramedics. At least another dozen there needed treatment that did not get taken to hospitals. We understand there are another 20 people as well who should have been on the train which are unaccounted for. Now, the entire train has been searched, so it's likely they just bought a ticket and didn't actually get on the train itself. But if any of those people are listening this morning, please get in touch with authorities as soon as you can. Tracy?
Yes, indeed. All right, Mark, thank you. Now to today's Gabrielle Boyle, who's at Central Station in Sydney, where the train departed. Gabby, do we know when the trains will be up and running again?
Tracy, good morning. Well, this service usually runs twice a day, once during the day and once at night, but it won't be running today. And in fact, it's not likely to be running for the next 4 or 5 days. And that is because of the length and the depth of this investigation. Investigators will take a look at every step of this journey, from the moment the train left Central Station here to the moment that that crash happened. They'll take a look at every section to try and work out exactly what has taken place. So no, at this stage, there will not be any services running between Sydney and Melbourne of this type, and we don't have any word yet on exactly when those will resume, Tracy.